First of all, to a pan, add 1/4 teaspoon methi seeds and 1 dried red chili. On a low flame, dry roast them until methi turns slightly aromatic. Then add 1/2 teaspoon cumin seeds and 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon peppercorns. Secondly, you can also coarsely crush it in a mortar pestle set aside. You can also skip this roasting pot and just powder the spices directly, but the aroma is great when roasted. Roast all of them until methi seeds turn slightly dark in color and aromatic. If making for baby or toddler, skip red chili and use less pepper. Cool them and add to a grinder jar. Add 1/2 tablespoon oil to a hot pot. When the oil turns hot, add 1/2 broken red chili, 1/2 teaspoon cumin seeds, and 1/2 teaspoon mustard seeds. Fourthly, soon they begin to splutter. Then add 3 to 4 crushed garlic, 1 spring curry leaves, and then a pinch of hing. Sauté well until the leaves turn crisp. Add 1 to 1/2 cups chopped or mashed tomatoes or pureed, about 2 to 3 medium tomatoes. Sprinkle 1/2 teaspoon salt and 1/8 teaspoon turmeric. Sixth step, cover and cook or short until the tomatoes turn mushy. Seventh step, add spice powder or rasam powder from step 1. Mix and sort for 2 to 3 minutes. The spice powder must smell good. Ninth step is pour 2 1/2 to 3 cups water. Add 1 teaspoon tamarind. Less is fine, but don't a lot. Add jaggery to taste. I use about 1 to 2 tablespoons to balance the flours. So adjust to your taste. Bring it to a boil and let simmer for 5 minutes. Rasam boiled on a low flame tastes good. Stir well and take little rasam in a tablespoon. Cool it and test and add more salt, tamarind and jaggery if needed. Final step is add 1/4 cup chopped coriander leaves with stock. Cover and turn off the stove. Serve rasam with rice and some pepper. Stir fry veggies.